Hello friends, this is your friend Sagar, and today I am discussing with you my projects that me and my teammates was making in our manual project that is in fourth semester. So our project is wholly based on the current problem data facing by the customers on the bank, like if you want to change your mobile, if you want to mobile number on the bank account, if you want to get the information about the loan and interest, whatever the interest are running on the current time, and if you want to deposit the amount, we have to do what, we have to stay in the line and we have to wait for our turn. That is a lot of wasted time in the bank. But here me and my team thinks that we have to do something to overcome these problems, and we're making a project here on Netbeans, and we give the title of our project as ATM automatic teller machine that we already know in the current generation. So I'm making here this project on Java Netbeans, that is a platform of Java. So I'm telling you the whole process how I can working here. This is the front end of my project. Okay, so I'm going to running it. Maybe by this by the help of my project you can get any idea and you can make it more better than me, than our team. So here, as you can see, the front end of ATM is ready, but here these buttons are disabled because I'm not entering the pin here and not the swipe a card. That is at that time the ATM is in the sleep position. If I entered here the wrong pin, it can tell me this is unauthorized user because the entered pin is not saved in his in its database. So here, firstly, I'm entering the wrong pin here. 1555 enter. As you see, invalid pin is pin you entered is now displaying here. Now again, I'm going to run it, and now this time I'm giving the correct pin here. So I'm giving the correct pin 1234. Click on the internet. As you see, these buttons are now active here. Now I'm clicking on the mobile update. I want to update my mobile here, and I have to enter the new mobile button, mobile number here. Suppose I'm entering here 7062257 4. That is my new mobile number, 00602574. Okay, so submit it. Yeah, your mobile number shall have to update shall have updated to 7006025574. That is a message alert to the user. If the if you are entering the correct mobile number, that is okay, then click on the update button. If you don't, if you think that the mobile number is not correct that you want to register on your mobile number, you can edit it from there. So click on the update button. So by the clicking on the update button, your data will be updated on your backend. And here, for the mobile update, I'm using here the API key that is that I can access here it from gateways. And here I'm using the platform like text local and standard. That is text local is the small for smallest small abbreviation of the text local platform. And now close it again. Run this program. Now this time you have to update your mobile number on your account. Now I'm checking here my balance here. So click on the balance button. As you see, a name, Sagar, and account number, this IFSC code and total amount is this that is displaying on your the window. And this is my balance section, and you can print the receipt from here. Click on the receipt button and print. Click on the print button. You can print by the using your printer. You can print the receipt from here. Now close it. As we see that when we have to turn, we have done our one transaction in the ATM, and automatically our ATM transaction timeout, and we have to swipe our card again if you want to do transaction again. So this is this purpose is used mainly for the security. So here the security is measured in the time of your money. So here I am submitting the my pin again here, 1234 enter. So here, as you see, my pin is not valid because I am just write 3-digit code here and it gives me invalid pin you entered. So now again I'm right here my correct pin, 1234 enter. Okay, the buttons are active. Now I'm going to withdraw my money from the account. Here, as you see, my total amount is here in this section is 5000 rupees. Now I'm withdraw here So as you see, the total amount is 5,000. I am withdrawing here for 2,300, and total amount, total balance is 47,700 rupees. So 50,000 rupees is my total amount. So I click on the receipt here. Sagar Raina, reference number this, account number this, and total amount is 50,000. I am withdrawing here 2,300, and the total balance is 47,700 rupees. So again, I'm running here. Running it for knowing the other features that we inserted here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, enter. Okay, as you see here, I am making a new option that you can't see in the ATM machines, like loan. Loan, as we if you remember that if you want to take the loan from the bank, you have to do what? You have to staying in a line, and when your terms arrive, you have to talk to the bank employee that, sir, I want to take the loan of 10 lakh rupees for 2 years. And then at that time, he are doing what? He is just telling you the total, the current interest rate is 5.7, 6.7, and whatever the current interest is. And by the interest, by the current interest you can got, if you want to take the loan 10 lakh rupees from the bank, you have to pay 10 lakh 30 rupees. 30,000, 10 lakh, 40,000, 11 lakh, and whatever the money is. But that wastes your time, because you have to go to the bank and staying in a queue. That is also a main purpose. And today's, as we know, that the time is a requirement. And here I'm giving the functionality here, like loan. By the help of your ATM, you can also check the loan, and you have to pay the loan amount from your ATM. You have to check whether the what is the current interest is here. If you, I want to take the loan of 10 lakh rupees for 2 years, what we have to pay, what I have to pay. And if I take 5 lakh rupees for 3 years, for 4 years, 5, 10 years, what I have to pay to the bank. So I'm clicking on the loan button again on it. 1, 2, 3, 4, enter. Here's the window of my loan button. Amount to loan, amount of loan, whatever you want to take. I'm taking here 1,20,000 rupees of amount for 3 years. And here yearly payment and total payment. Yes, yearly payment, you have to give the yearly payment of 52,000 rupees, 52,000 rupees, and total payment is 1,56,000 rupees. Means to say that if you want to take a loan of 1,20,000 rupees from the bank for 3 years, you have to pay 52,000 per year, and for 3 years you have to pay total 1,56,000 rupees. Okay, now click on the receipt. As you see, my receipt here is loan management system, and this is the reference number. Amount of loan that I want to take from the bank is 1,20,000 rupees, and current interest rate is 10%, and the yearly that I want to pay again to the bank, back to the bank, is 3 years. And yearly payment is 52,000, and total payment is 1,56,000. Means to say that I have to pay 36,000 more to the bank if I want to take the loan of 1,20,000 rupees for the 3 years. So click on the exit button. Now, my last functionality is to deposit the amount on the bank. That currently on the current time that are available on the only SBI ATMs. But when my team, me and my team are working on this project, at that time there is unavailability of SBI ATMs. Like you can't deposit the amount on the SBI ATMs, but the SBI gives you of this type of functionality before 2 or 3 months ago. Now click on the enter button. I am deposit the amount here. Here, balance information with deposit, name Sagar, and account number this. Here I'm deposit amount of 22,30,000 rupees, and my previous amount is 2,10,000 rupees, and the total amount is 4,40,000 rupees 0.23. So click on the receipt button. As you see, the name of my account holder, account number, IFSC code, and total amount is before deposit here is 2,10,000 rupees. Now you have to you have deposited here 2,30,000 rupees. Now the total amount is 4,40,000 rupees in your account. So you can print here or print the receipt here. So click on the exit button. So guys, this is our project for project that we're making for our minor section. So if you like this project, please like this video, share this video, and subscribe my channel for more upcoming videos. And I hope by this project you can get some logics that what type of project you have to choose for your minor or major project what you want to make. So thanks guys, thanks a lot.